Buckle up and hold on. At our church, we love God. Make no mistake about that. At our church, we believe in God's radical, unconditional, and unwavering love for us. At our church, we believe that Jesus is God. We also affirm that you may or may not believe that Jesus is God. And we're not asking you to change your belief system before you attend our church. We're simply inviting you on a journey toward Jesus. For years, churches have placed a high priority on Jesus as the get-out-of-hell-free card. At our church, we place the highest priority on Jesus as a live life to the fullest invitation. At our church, we believe every person has a dream deep inside their hearts, and that God put that dream there, not for our glory, but for His. At our church, we're not concerned with where you've been, but where you're going. At our church, we believe that the Bible is God's Word. It is real, it is living, it is active. We believe that people who don't go to church anywhere are not the enemy. They are real people who need the perfect love that only God can give. And we believe that God gives this love through, of all people, us. At our church, we do not and we will not display a holier-than-thou attitude toward anyone. We are all broken people, but He is putting us back together. And finally, and most importantly, at our church, we believe that Jesus really lived, that He really died on a cross, and that He really rose again on the third day. And we cannot and we will not candy coat or water down that message, ever. Today, you've chosen to sit yourself in the middle of a very safe place to hear a potentially dangerous message. Welcome to our church.
Good morning. Welcome to Crosspointe Biker Church. Everybody stand this morning and praise the Lord with us.
Slay. secret. Who taught the sun where to stand in the morning? And who told the ocean you can only come this far? And who showed the moon where to hide till the evening? Whose words alone testifies, and this life within me cry, I know my Redeemer lives. The very same God who spins everything in orbit, he runs to the weary, the worn and the weak. But those same gentle hands, they hold me when I'm broken, and they conquer death to bring me victory. Yes, I know my Redeemer. All of creation testifies.
Ask me how it is I'm still standing. You wonder how I've made it through this storm. I can't boast of any special powers. There's no secret, I just held on. And I held on till the storm was over. I don't claim to be a hero, and I don't have all the answers, but I held on until the storm was over. Not because I'm good, not because I'm great, not because I'm strong, I just held on. I can tell that things are finally happening. I have blessings I can call my own. Many times wondered if I was gonna make it, but while I was still wondering, I just kept holding on, and I held on until the storm was over. I don't claim to be a hero, and I don't have all the answers, but I just held on. Not because I'm great, not because I'm strong, I just just build on.
I don't know exactly who I'm talking to. But y'all missed a great service, first service. Holy Spirit was here. And I don't know who's here, who's watching online, or who's going through those storms. But I've been through my fair share. Last week, sometimes life just gets tough. Things pop up on Facebook. My mom, she was going through she loved a scrapbook, and she got behind, and we got a room in our house back home, my old bedroom. It's just stacked. I don't even know how you could develop that many pictures. Just oodles of them. And she been sending pictures of Grandpa and just everybody in the family. Sometimes when we're going through them storms and we think life's not fair and you feel like the devil's won all around and things happen that's out of your control and you don't want to happen, and if you could have changed them, you would. This song hits me right dead in the nose. Mom sent me a picture of, I wasn't much over 21. And Wes wasn't very old. God can repair relationships. I'm not trying to embarrass you, Wes. I'm proud of you. But I thought I got something stole from me. And by the world's standards, I did. Everything you work for is your kids, right? I got that picture sent to me, and I'm holding Wes. He's not even 6 months old. Hunter's grown up. I'm proud of her. I've always told her I don't want grandkids. I want to be able to ride. I don't need them. Y'all play with them. But when Wes stepped back in my life and he brought that baby, God does restore. And he will restore families. And I don't know who I'm talking to this morning. I may be talking to myself. But there's things that happen in your life. It don't even have to do with kids. I mean, just sickness, whatever's going on. God will restore. He may not heal you, but he will restore you. And somebody's here today with a wall 6 foot tall. We're going to preach on it today, but God wants to fix you, but he will not fix you until you allow him to fix you. And you have to come clean. You have to give it all up. You have to throw it all on the table, even as ugly as it looks. Because when we started this church, I throwed all my laundry on the front of the table and let y'all just go through it one at a time. I don't have nothing to hide. Somebody here today needs to let that go. Somebody on Facebook needs to let it go. We'll let them sing his song. This front's open. If you got something to let go, today is the day. Because when you let go of it, you can breathe again. You can live life again. And it may feel like it's the end of the world today. But 24 years ago, I thought my life was done. And today it's not. Today it's the best it's ever been. It's because I allowed God to step in and make something out of the mess that I helped create. And He can do the same for you. Don't leave this place holding on to garbage. Don't leave this place holding on to something that you have no business holding on to. Because I promise He'll fix you if you let Him.
I can tell that things are finally happening. I have blessings I can call my own. See, many times I wondered if I could make it. While I was wondering, I just held on. And I held on till the storm was over. I don't claim to be a hero, and I don't have all the answers, but I held on till the storm was over. It's not because I'm good, not because I'm great, not because I'm strong, I just held on.
I thought by now they'd fall, but You have never failed me yet. Waiting for change to come, knowing the battle's won. For You have never failed me yet. Your promise still stands. Great is Your faithfulness, Your faithfulness. I'm still in Your hands.
This is my confidence. You never fail. You're still enough. Keep me within your love. My heart will sing your praise again. Your promise still stands. Great is your faith.
My confidence, you never
never failed us. You're always with us, and you'll never forsake us. And Lord, I thank you so much for your presence here this morning. Your word says that you would send a comforter known as the Holy Spirit. And we can feel his presence in this room this morning. God, we praise you. We thank you. We thank you that we're able to gather together in your name once again. And God, have your hand on Pastor Chris this morning and the message he's going to give. In Jesus' name, amen.